Welcome to the interstellar space. This is where our journey begins, in the cold infinity that spans longer than the eye can see. The temperature is a few degrees above absolute zero. It's only heated by the cosmic background radiation from the Big Bang. In some regions, matter will group, and here we find interstellar clouds. This is where stars are born. Let's fly into the cloud and see how the cosmic ocean of molecules is primarily empty space. The temperature is around 20 Kelvin, and most of the atoms in the clouds are hydrogen. The low temperature implies that the molecules have a low speed. The gas pressure is small. That means gravity can compress the cloud if it's stronger than the pressure inside the cloud. A typical cloud can be around 50 parsec long and contain millions of solar masses of material. But what if suddenly there are disruptions in the interstellar cloud? Let's perceive the cloud as point particles to illustrate a collapse like this. Because our universe is huge, a lot of processes that might produce interruptions in the cloud could happen. For instance, a supernova could interfere with the cloud and produce a pressure wave that would collapse the cloud. Typically, it's only a small part of the huge cloud that collapses. Let's look at a section of the cloud. The cloud will compress due to the gravity and rotate. The rotating cloud will therefore have an angular momentum. At the same time, there are magnetic fields due to charged particles in the cloud. The magnetic field will deflect particles out of the cloud and it will lose angular momentum. Let's zoom out of the cloud. Here's the pressure wave that causes the collapse. While the cloud rotates and loses angular momentum, a circumstellar disk will arise. In the center of the disk, a protostar is being formed. Meanwhile, protoplanets will form around the protostar. Dust, particles, and asteroids will collide with the protostars and protoplanets and increase their size. Let's look at the star as a compact object. The star is being compressed due to gravity, and the density becomes extremely big in the core. The temperature rises. When the temperature is around a few million kelvins, the hydrogen will become plasma and produce fusion power. This great outward-going energy from the core balances the inward-going pressure from the gravity. This balance is called the hydrostatic equilibrium. If we zoom out, we can see how the star pulses when the hydrostatic equilibrium is maintained. Gravity compresses the star, but pressure photons keep it from collapsing. Look at the particles. We are in the center of the star where energy production takes place. Here you can see how hydrogen fuses to helium by the PP process. It's a part of the CNO cycle. For heavy stars, this process will continue until iron is formed. After that, it isn't possible to fusion atoms heavier than iron. Here is a chaotic fusion process inside a star. When there's not enough fuel for the fusion process, the stars can generate the energy necessary to maintain the hydrostatic equilibrium. The core collapses. For heavy stars, the star will explode as a supernova explosion, leaving a neutron star. For even heavier stars, the neutrons will also be compressed by gravity and form a black hole. We are in space and streaming a Type 2 supernova explosion directly on the TV. Look behind you. The energy and luminosity released by a supernova explosion is enormous. The luminosity is comparable to a whole galaxy. The blue light is from a supernova explosion and the purple is from a galaxy. Here's the Crab Nebula, an interstellar cloud. It's formed from a supernova explosion. A supernova explosion therefore creates new opportunities for new stars to form. The cosmic cycle repeats.